coward shy away, come to take the throne. To conquer world powers, bring Jacob home. I'm quarterbacking like Jake DeLong, like Mount Rushmore, I got a face of stone.
I want to start off by saying, call alone Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shah. That's all praises to the Heavenly Father, through his only begotten Son, who the world ignorantly called Jesus Christ.
That's right.
Y'all know we are here to do week in and week out. Yeah, we the Israelites are here to teach you so-called Blacks, Latinos, Native and Seminole Indians how to come back and serve the Lord in the right way, man. Because all the lies been perpetuated and y'all serving the Lord in the wrong way, all right? Don't you want to learn the right way? All right? What about you, bro? You want to learn the right way, don't you? Huh? This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 6, verse 16.
Go ahead.
Thus saith Yahweh.
Thus saith Yahweh, you know.
Stand ye in the ways and see and ask for the old path. Yeah. Ask for the old path. So that's why we out here to show you so-called Blacks and Latinos the old path of the heaven, that the Heavenly Father set grounds for us to follow by, all right? To rule and govern ourselves by, all right? The old path, go ahead. Where is the good way?
And where is the good way, you know?
And walk therein.
Yeah, walk therein, go ahead.
And ye shall find rest for your souls. But they said, we will not walk therein.
Yeah, you will find rest for your souls if you walk upright to the Heavenly Father. You know what I'm saying? That's what the Lord looking for. Blesses the man that stand out in the way of counsel of the sinners, man. All right, so you got to be walking upright and find rest for your soul. I know our people, they always working. Big Mama always talking about, I was working 20 years and doing this and that. I'm tired on my feet. All right, don't you want some rest for your soul? And the only rest you're going to get is coming back to Yahweh.
But they said, we will not walk therein.
Yeah, y'all don't want to walk therein. All right, y'all want to walk in the ways of Satan, man. Not Yahweh, man. So you so-called Blacks and Latinos, y'all got to come and get right and walk in the path that the Lord has set and dictated for y'all, God.
Also, I set watchmen over you.
Yeah, we set watchmen. Who the watchmen? Oh, us, the prophets out here that's coming and speaking the word of truth and sincerity to our people out here.
That's right.
What y'all need to be listening to, not damn T.D. Jakes, a Creflo Dollar, man. All right? All he want to do is take your damn money, all right? We ain't asking for money. You come for free and get knowledge, man. All right, go ahead.
I'm ready again. Also, I set watchmen over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet.
Yeah, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. Hey, how y'all doing today? You doing all right, man? You believe in Jesus Christ? Huh? Can I show you something Jesus Christ said? Give me Luke 19:27. Let me show you something he said. You think Christ, like, he probably was a peaceful person, you think, huh? That's right. This scripture gonna tell you right here. That's a good answer. He actually read, man. Go ahead.
Yeah, this is Luke 19:27.
Go ahead.
But those my enemies,
Christ said, those my enemies, who the enemies of the Lord, God,
which would not that I should reign over them.
They don't want the Lord, don't want Christ to reign over them, you know?
Bring hither,
mean bring them over here, God.
And slay them.
And do what?
Slay them.
The Lord said, slay them, God.
Before me.
So Christ want people, Christ want his enemies dead.
That's right.
Think about that. Well, you said he destroyed for right, so that basically goes along with what you're saying, right?
Get it.
Right, then, so what you think he means when he say love your enemies? What's your name, by the way, man?
I'm Dave.
Dave, all right, Dave. Yeah. You ain't got to give me no dap. You going to do me like that on camera? I'm on COVID anyway. What you said? But what, you say you're not a great Christian?
I believe it against God, because I don't know enough about the Bible that I should.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
No way, so you don't know?
I consider myself a Christian. I guess I'm not good enough Christian to know what the Bible says.
Know the Bible, because I'm going to show you the true Christians. Let me ask 10:26.
Bring it out, all right?
You got to be a follower of Christ to be a true Christian. All right? Do you follow Christ?
I do. Christ said, that's not good, that's not the best I said.
Yeah, you're offended. You've been offending right.
Every day.
Let me show you something. You know what I mean. 1 John 3. You can't be doing all this sinning. What would you think Christ would feel like if you sinned? Watch this. Let me show you a scripture. Because you got to stop it.
This is 1 John chapter 3, verse 8. He that committeth sin.
So you commit sin every day, right?
Go ahead. Is of the devil.
Of the devil. So how could you be of Christ and you sinning every day of the devil?
Huh?
Christ wants you to sin, huh?
No.
You repent, so you just keep. So you can willfully.
That's right.
What is that? He said, I am of the devil.
Acts 13 and 10. Let
me show you. He know who he is. Like,
who's repentance for?
The Lord Jesus, my God.
I'm saying, who is according to the Bible, who can repent?
Paul.
Yeah, you're right. Paul can repent because he's an Israelite.
That's
let me show you. Give me a repentance for Israel. Acts 5 and 10. I'm already
there. That's right.
Let me show you who repented. I'm trying to teach you something, man. All right?
Listen, man. This is Acts chapter 5, verse 30.
Said,
I'm open to criticism.
That's right, man. Go ahead.
Acts chapter 5, verse 30. Okay. The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom ye slew and hanged on a tree. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior. For to give repentance.
To give repentance. So it's the next line is going to show you who can only repent.
Go ahead. Give repentance to Israel.
To Israel. So the only people that can repent is the Israelites. Are you an Israelite? If you're not an Israelite, then you are the devil, man. You know that?
That's right!
The Bible said, you said you sin every day, and the Bible said who committed sin is that a devil.
I wish I could argue against you. That's why I need to step up my game and read the Bible more so I can argue against you. That's why I'm getting wrong right here.
But listen, it ain't going to happen like reading the Bible. The Lord got to open your mind to this. You can't just wake up and say, let me read the Bible. You know what I'm saying?
This is Psalms chapter 50, verse 16. But unto the wicked,
read on.
God saith, what hast thou to do to declare my statutes?
Uh-huh,
or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth?
You can't take this in your mouth. This is only for the Lord's sheep, for the peculiar people, the Israelites. So you can open this up all you want, but you ain't going to be able to get the understanding because it's only meant for the Israelites. And you said you're not an Israelite, right? You said you were the devil, right? Okay, let's see. Let me show. Give me Mark. Give me Matthew 4:17. Let's see who Christ said follow him. Let's see who are the only people in the Bible that Christ said to follow him. Watch this.
It's the book of Matthew chapter 4:17.
Watch this.
For that time, Jesus, verse 19, and he said unto me, follow me.
He said unto me. He talking to Israelites. He talking to Simon Peter and his brother.
And I will make you. He said, follow me.
Follow me. The context is he only talking to Israelites. Go ahead.
And I will make you fishers of men.
So the only people that can follow Christ is Israelites.
That's right!
You think God hates people according to
Christ?
Oh, let's see. Romans 9 and 13.
You just bring it out, all right?
Hey, chill out, Gideon. One more verse for you go.
All right, baby.
You good? I just got one verse for you to show you that education.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 9 and 13.
Paul wrote this. Romans 9 and 13.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
Jacob have you loved, go ahead.
But Esau have I hated.
The Lord said he hated Esau. You heard that in the Bible?
Alright, so God do hate people, right?
What does the Bible say?
Read it again. Break this down.
Romans 9 and 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
Jacob have I loved.
But Esau have I hated.
Yeah, I don't have the right words to fight that.
That's hate. You say God hate, right? Bible. According to that scripture, you say he hate people, right?
This is direct. And check this out, this is Sirach 12 and verse 6. For the Most High hateth sinners.
The Most High hateth sinners. Read it again.
For the Most High hateth sinners.
God hates sinners according to the Bible.
Bible.
So you agree? The Bible said it. What you looking at?
Bring it up. Are you serious? Oh my God. Okay. This is Matthew chapter 11, verse 20. Then began he to upbraid the cities where most of his mighty works were done, because they repented not.
They repented not. The Israelites didn't repent. So he upbraided the cities. You know what upbraid mean in Greek? It means to revile. Basically, he rebuked them because they didn't repent. The Israelites were stiff-necked people.
Woe unto thee, Chorazin. Woe unto thee, Bethsaida. For if the mighty works which were done in you had been done in Tyre and Zidon,
are y'all listening? These Canaanites, Tyre and Zidon. You say what?
Oh, she's about 15. Okay, 28. I'm about to say. This is Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. Come unto me, all ye that are that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Okay, who are you talking to? No, he's not talking to the Israelites.
Let's see. Let me get this real fast. Let's see if you're talking about our people. Matthew chapter 15, verse 14. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
He's talking to the Israelites. The Israelites were weird. They was in captivity. Huh? I'm going to show you. How I know I'm what?
Bring it out.
I'm not an Israelite. I am an Israelite because I know according to the Bible and through the Spirit what my people, what the Israelites is going to go through, and my forefathers went through the same thing.
That's right.
Hold on, Mom. What you say? You're a Christian, but you don't follow Christ. It's Christ. What color is Christ according to the Bible? Yes, it do.
What does the Bible
mean? Hey, hold on fast. You said if you went through what your forefathers went through, you wouldn't be a Christian. Y'all forefathers had us in slavery and were Christians.
Mennonites, what's that?
They like Amish.
Y'all Russian?
They like Amish.
Y'all Russian? No, Russians ain't had no slaves. Y'all Caucasian? Are y'all Caucasians? Yes, y'all are. What are you talking about? Hey, that's just like saying a Haitian not black just because he ain't Haiti. You Caucasian.
Yeah. You ain't got no belief. You believe in Satan.
This is Jeremiah 3:23. Hey, look at the damn golden girls. Get ready for slavery. Go ahead. This is Jeremiah 3:23. Truly in vain is salvation hoped for
from the hill.
That's it. Hey, yeah, get out of here, man. Get ready for slavery. All right, with your bad knee. Get your easy. Go get surgery on your knee and come back, okay? Give me 80 arm. Give me some 81 and 15. They bugged out, man. That's what I thought she could at least with the John 3:16.
Hey, who can repent? Paul. At least he admitted.
That's right.
Wait a minute. At least he admitted he was the damn devil. Yeah,
right? He admitted.
At least when he admitted my play, he
said that's why he repented every day. This is Psalms 81. Psalms 81 and 15. The haters of the Lord.
Yeah, the haters of the Lord, man.
It's a lot of haters of the Lord. We see that week in, week out, day in and day out. Y'all really hate the Heavenly Father. Give me Proverbs 8:36. Go ahead. The haters of the Lord should have submitted themselves. The haters of the Lord should have submitted themselves unto him.
Yeah, the haters of the Lord should have submitted themselves to the Lord. Alright, you should submit yourself to the Lord instead of hating him. Alright, why you hating on the Lord, man? Alright, the Heavenly Father Yahweh. Okay?
But their time.
Get ready for slavery, Becky.
But their time should have endured forever.
Yeah, their time should have endured forever, man. Alright? If you would have came to the Lord, your time would endure forever. But now since y'all hate the Lord, y'all not gonna get them out. Y'all come on. Hey, how y'all doing today? Y'all believe in Christ?
Okay.
Can I show y'all scripture? Can I show your scripture in Christ here?
Sure.
You know.
That's the book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Christ said he only came to the Israelites. No, are you an Israelite?
His blood is on the Israelites. Let me show you that. Matthew 27:25. Good question. That's all. We don't have intellectual dialogue. One more. Let me show you one question. All right, get ready for slavery. Dan Roseanne. All right.
Hey, y'all supposed to be Christian, but y'all dressed up like Harry Potter people. This is Exodus 22, verse 18. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live.
Suffer a witch to live. The hell out of here. Yeah, you're a baby.
This book of Proverbs, chapter 8, verse 36. But he that sinneth against me,
the Lord said, he that sinneth against me. That's what the Lord said. You so-called blacks and Latinos that sin against the Lord. He said, he that sinneth against me, God,
wrongeth his own soul.
Wrongeth your own soul. You're doing yourself a disservice. So that's why we out here to show you so-called blacks and Latinos to come to the right way, man. To come back to worshiping the Heavenly Father in truth and in spirit. All right, because that's what y'all need. Y'all ain't no truth out here. It's a bunch of lies. They're perpetuated out here, all right? So that's why y'all ain't got no truth, right?
All they that hate me love death.
Yeah, all they that hate the Lord, what?
Love death.
Yeah, y'all love death. You so-called blacks and Latinos, y'all love death because y'all hate the Lord. That's why Psalms 81:15 said that haters of the Lord should have submitted themselves, man. All right, so y'all got to submit to the Heavenly Father, because if you don't do it voluntarily, he going to make you do it. You need to get down and lay down.
All right. This is the book of Tobit, chapter 12, verse 10. But they that sin are enemies to their own life.
Yeah, they that sin are enemies to your own life. So basically, yo, you don't even want your life to prolong you. All right, give me this in Proverbs 3.
All right, this is 2 Esau 1:25.
Seeing ye have forsaken me.
Yeah, y'all forsaken the Heavenly Father.
Every day in and day out, even when we out here trying to tell y'all, y'all still forsaking Yahweh, man. Go ahead.
I will forsake you also.
Yeah, he said he gonna forsake you also. So that's why a lot of y'all getting forsaken out here, like you're saying.
What
is
that? What that is?
Since you rejected me, I will reject
your children.
Yeah. Your children, no, you don't gotta go there. Your children shall be no priest to me. So that's why y'all children, the children walking around all bugged the hell out, man. Alright, go ahead.
I will forsake you also. I will forsake you also. When you desire me to be gracious unto you, I shall have no mercy upon you.
Yeah, the Lord not gonna have no mercy if you don't come back in truth and try your best to do the right thing day in and day out and have a faith in your heart. Trust in Yahweh and had a faith in his son, Yahweh. All right? That's what it's all about, having that faith. That's what it's going to come down to. All right? With faith, that's how Enoch was saying, man. Right? What's it say? Yeah. That's what.
Whensoever you shall call upon me, I will not hear you.
Yeah, the Lord said he will not hear you. I hear the Lord ears is closed to you so-called blacks and Latinos that don't want to come back to the Lord after you hear this, man. All right, so once you hear this, you got to at least try to make some type of adjustment in your life to try to head to the right path. Good.
For you had defiled your hands with blood.
With blood. Your hands are defiled with blood, man. We see that day in, day out with all these murders out here. Your hands are defiled with blood. So that's why we come out here to get blood off our hands, man. All right? To do the work of the Lord, to do what we're supposed to do, God.
Your feet are swift to commit manslaughter.
Man.
I ain't never heard that. Man. Go ahead, read that again.
Yeah, and your feet are swift to commit manslaughter.
Yeah, your feet are swift to commit manslaughter. Y'all ready to slide on the damn op, man? All right? Ready to commit manslaughter, you know? And man one, God.
Ye have not, as it were, you forsaken me, but your own selves.
Yeah, the Lord said y'all have forsaken your own selves. Just like it reiterated in Proverbs 8:36. He that sinneth against me, wrongeth your own soul, man. All right, so it's time to come back to the Lord. I know you so-called blacks and Latinos, y'all tired of being in this low calamity. I mean, this low estate that y'all in with the calamities of the Lord coming upon y'all because y'all disobeying him. Y'all revolted and gone. And you give me Jeremiah 5:22.
Look at 2 Esau 5:8. there shall be a confusion also in many places.
Yeah, a confusion and also many places. There's a lot of damn confusion out here, man. All right, every time we go, damn bocce boys running rampant. We don't know what the hell is going on, God.
And the fire shall be off sent out again. And the wild beasts shall change their places.
And the wild beasts shall change their places, you know.
And mistress women,
you know,
shall bring forth monsters.
Bring forth
monsters.
Monsters. That's what a lot of these jakes are, damn monsters, man, all right? When you try to tell them the word of the Lord, they don't want to hear it, man. So mistress women shall bring forth monsters. And that's what we see out here, damn monsters, man. All right, they say they demons. They telling it. They tell you they on demon time. They monsters out here. Go ahead.
Yeah. And this is Jeremiah 5:22. Fear ye not me.
The Lord said, fear ye not me. If any y'all damn fear, y'all fear the damn feds from kicking in your door, but y'all don't fear the Lord. All right, that's what the Lord asking you so-called blacks and Latinos. Fear ye not me, huh? Go ahead.
Saith the Lord, will you not tremble at my presence?
Will you not tremble at my presence? All right, like y'all damn tremble when Debo walk down the block, but when the Lord come, the Lord bring his judgment, all right, then y'all want to tremble, but y'all ain't trembling before that because the Lord known by his judgment. Give me Psalms 9:16.
Which have placed the sand for the bound of the sea.
Read on.
By a perpetual decree.
Hey, excuse me, sir. Can I show you something? What's your ethnicity, man? You're Hispanic?
You on the way, man. That it cannot pass. Uh-huh. And though the waves thereof toss themselves, yet can they not prevail.
Read on.
Though they roar, yet they cannot pass over.
Go ahead.
But this people,
you so-called blacks and Latino, this people, God.
But this people have a revolting and a rebellious heart.
Yeah, y'all got a revolting and a rebellious heart. Because when somebody tell y'all the right thing to do, y'all still want to buck up against it, man. I understand when you're ignorant and not knowing, the Lord will wink at your ignorance. But once you learn what you're supposed to do, the right path, y'all still want to rebel against that. Y'all a bunch of them old Miss rebels, man, God.
They are revolted and gone.
Y'all revolted and y'all damn gone, man. All right? So far gone. All right? Who's on it, Rose? Nah, I'm so not. Who's single?
That's Monica.
Monica.
Yeah.
Y'all damn so gone like Monica, man. All right?
Go ahead, give me that.
What you want?
Can I take Nah. Oh, you said Song B?
Nah, you
could. I'll tell you. After they know the truth. This is Hebrews 10:26. For if we sin willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there have made him no more sacrifice for sin.
Yeah, so y'all got to come back to the Lord and y'all got to do the right thing once y'all hear the truth. Start making the right actions to come back to the Lord, all right? Because that's what the true worship is going to do. His sheep hear his voice and we going to act. You're going to act on what you're supposed to do, man. So that's all we out here to teach you so-called blacks and Latinos. Come back to the Lord and do what you're supposed to do, all right? It ain't that hard. It ain't hard as they make it, you know what I'm saying?
Give me Isaiah 26.
The book of Isaiah chapter 26 verse 1.
Okay.
In that day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah.
Yeah, in that day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah, man. What's that song we gonna be singing? The elect, Lord willing, we are the men gonna be singing. Give me that Revelation 14:3.
Revelation 14:3.
Go ahead.
And they sung as it were a new song.
Go ahead. They sung as it was a new song. This doctrine we singing. This the only song we singing and we worried about, all right? The song of the Heavenly Father and His Son.
Go ahead. Before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders.
Uh-huh.
And no man can learn that song.
Yeah, no man should learn that. No man can learn that song. All right? You can't go on damn Google and type in the lyrics to this song and learn it. All right? The Lord got to instill it in you, God.
But the 144,000.
The governing body, of the elect.
Go ahead. Which were redeemed from the earth.
Yeah, which were redeemed from the earth. Because them the men that left off their wicked ways and meddled with them no more. Tried their best to rehearse the righteous acts. It was perfect in the sight of the Most High. Through Yahawashah, having faith in Yahawashah, they were made righteous. Go ahead.
Verse 4. These are they which were not defiled with women.
Was not defiled with women. What's that talk about? That strange woman. That ain't talking about being a damn virgin. You damn Christians. You can't have a woman.
Well, the 144,000 can't have a woman. Get
the hell out of here, man. That ain't talking about that. Okay?
Oh, for they are virgins.
These.
Hey,
a Christian takes that and be like, you can't have no woman. I'm out of here. I talk about that strange woman, them other doctrines. We can't be tossed to and fro. Give me a few others. Hey, how you doing, man? Hey, what's his name? Tom Hanks running. This is Isaiah. I'm just gonna read it again. Isaiah 26 from the top. And in that day. And that day shall this song be sung. How y'all doing, man? What's up with it, bro? What's y'all ethnicity? Y'all Ethiopian?
Eritrean? Ethiopian.
Ethiopian? That's what I just said. Yeah.
Are you saying Ethiopian?
Yeah, Ethiopian. Y'all come from the Cushites in the Bible, the Babylonians. Yeah. Nebuchadnezzar. Yeah, y'all know y'all had the Israelites in slavery. We the Israelites, the so-called blacks. You know the blacks that came. You know the. Let me show you a scripture. Give me that for the Ethiopians. Let me show you a scripture for y'all, cause y'all know. Hold on, y'all know the Nebuchadnezzar. You know Nebuchadnezzar. He was an Ethiopian, so-called Ethiopian. Nebuchadnezzar in the Bible. Babylonian, yeah. Cushite. Y'all know what that is. They had the Israelites in slavery. So the Lord got a judgment for everybody who had the Israelites in slavery. And we the real Israelites. We came on slave ships. God.
Yeah, this is Zephaniah 2 and 12.
Ye Ethiopians. All right, that's y'all. Yeah, there you go. God.
Also, you shall be slain by my sword.
He said he's going to be slain by the Lord's sword. Think about that. He said, ye Ethiopians shall be slain by my sword.
We're Muslim.
Y'all Muslim? It don't matter. Y'all still Ethiopian.
No, we don't believe in the Bible.
Okay. Hey, no. Don't the Quran teach you to believe in the Bible? Yes, you do. We got Abraham. Where did Ishmael? Ishmael, where did he come from? Abraham, right?
Ishmael
came from who?
Abraham.
Where Abraham at?
In the Bible. Yeah, this is the Quran. This is Surah 2 and 122. Oh, children of Israel.
Oh, children of Israel. This is what the Quran say, God.
Remember my favor that I bestowed upon you. By choosing.
No, we say, no. That's
not the Quran.
That's not the Quran. Hey,
that's not the Quran.
Do you?
It has to be in Arabic.
You speak Arabic? Give it to him in Arabic. I want you to speak it.
All right, let's
pull
see.
It up in Arabic. You speak Arabic?
Yeah.
All right, we'll read it. Get it. Find it in Arabic.
I'm not from what difference would it make.
Maybe.
That English is various from the Arabic.
He's
going to say the same thing.
He's going to say the same thing.
Also, he's going to say some
blue. He ain't going to say Israel. We teaching who the true Israelites of the Bible are, right? The so-called blacks, Latinos, Native and Seminole Indians that came in slavery. We the chosen people.
So, if we are the great Israelites.
Yeah, the great Israelites who Christ came from.
For
what? We the chosen people. We stand on high. Our people think they're low. They don't know. They don't know how intelligent they are. My people that's in the hood, they don't know who they are. You say what? I know it's fucked up.
We're kings.
No, but listen. Hold on. We didn't grow up over here in America in the trenches. We didn't grow up knowing that. So we out here telling our people who they really are. That's our aim. That's what we out here to tell our people, because our people don't know that for the most part.
We're black too.
Y'all black what? He don't believe in the Bible. Man, get this man. Get the double-minded man. Jewish, but you don't believe in the Bible? Not Christ a Jew? Okay, are Jew is Christ. Was Christ, are the Jews in the Bible?
No.
Oh my God. Come on. Come on, you playing games. Oh, you Christian? Okay, man, so you denied the Father in front of men. Give me that. I'm gonna show you. You just denied the Son.
Give me that. This is Jeremiah 13 and 23. Can the Ethiopian change his skin?
Can the Ethiopian change his skin? No.
Or the leprosy, y'all try.
Hey, he's a damn comedian. He's a comedian, man. All right, go ahead.
Can the Ethiopian change his skin?
No.
Or the leper his spots? For they that also do good, that are accustomed to do evil.
Yeah, you're accustomed to do evil, man. Go back to your booty and have a nice day, all right? All right, the hell out of here. Man, I want to...
Man, this is the book of Matthew chapter 10, verse 33. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven.
He was cut. That's what I wanted. I was waiting for y'all to get it. I'm like, you going to Jeremiah? Why you going to Jeremiah? That ain't it.
That nigga, he grabbed his
shit. That was going to get out of here.
Read it. Well, I told him
to get it. Read that again. Nah, he good. Read that again.
Nah, man, he ain't good. Give me a good minute. This is Matthew 10, verse 33, right? It says, but whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny.
Hey, would you ever deny Christ in front of men?
You'll never deny. Oh, that's right. You don't deny Christ. Damn, Mike said it, man.
Matthew 10, 33. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven.
Yeah, you're denied. He'll just sort of look, but he's gonna get denied anyway.
So he really can do what he wanna do anyway. So there ain't no wrong way.
No, funny. He said he don't believe in the Bible.
He was playing.
Christian,
but
I said
that
nigga denied anyway.
Damn, nigga making
it
everything.
Oh, nigga, I bet you. At first he said he was
the mother. He said he wanted to get the Egyptian.
Yeah. How you doing, sir? You believe in Christ? You like a high school superstar quarterback, man. Yeah, I'm close, man. All right.
That was great, squad.
This is book Isaiah chapter 26. It says, in that day shall this song be sung in the land of Judah.
Song gonna be sung in the land of Judah, which the elect gonna be singing. All right, Lord, like, Lord, what are we other men that we be singing that song? Go ahead.
We have a strong city. Salvation will God appoint for the walls and the bulwarks.
Yeah, we got a strong city. So the Lord gonna make us, we gonna have a strong city. Can't nobody gonna be able to take us down. We gonna rule forever and ever, man. All right? And the salvation is for the Israelites, go ahead.
Open ye the gates.
Y'all can come learn the Bible, all right? You believe in Christ, man? Did I show you something to say?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, good.
Oh, we got
dark. I don't want to name another Central Park where y'all get innocent brothers arrested, man.
Right. Open ye the gates that the righteous nation.
Yeah, open ye the gates that the righteous nation. We know who the righteous, according to Deuteronomy 6 and 25. The righteous and peculiar nation is the Israelites.
Go ahead. Which keepeth the truth.
Keepeth the what?
Keepeth the truth.
Yeah, keepeth the truth. What's the Lord's truth? His commandments, his word. All right, who keepeth the truth? Only the Israelites. How you doing, man? All right, go ahead.
May enter in. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace.
Yeah, well, perfect peace. And that day that we're going to have peace. All right, we ain't got to worry about the other nations. All that's going on right now. And that day when we rule them, we're going to have peace.
Go ahead. That will keep them in perfect peace, whose mind has stayed on thee,
but mind has stayed on the Lord,
because he trusted in thee.
He trusted in thee. Give me Psalms 118:8. You got to trust in the Lord. All right, that's the only way you're going to have peace, is having trust in Yahweh. All right, if you ain't got trust in him, you ain't gonna make it. You got trust in damn Joe. Damn, what's a Sleepy Joe or damn Jim Crow Joe? You're finished. Damn Sloppy Joe is gonna shut down everything. You niggas ain't gonna be able to do nothing again. But y'all go to the damn polls. My damn cousin gonna go vote for Joe Biden. That's damn mine. He my age. Okay? That's Psalms 118 and verse 8. It is better to trust in your house.
That's how Trump gave you 1,200, and that's how you treat him.
Hey, Trump gave you niggas 1,200, and that's how y'all would pay him, man. Right? Okay.
And it's better to trust in the Lord.
Yeah, it's better to trust in the Lord, you know?
Than to put confidence in man.
Than to put confidence in man. So you got to trust in Yahweh, man. All right, that's what we out here to teach y'all, to renew your mind, to have trust in the Lord and have faith in his son. All right? That's what we coming with. That's our angle to the damn Ethiopian, man. All right?
Damn Cush.
Verse 4.
Damn Cush.
Where the hell, where do you think they was headed?
Trust ye in the Lord forever.
Forever.
For in the Lord, Yahweh, is everlasting strength.
Yeah, everlasting strength. That's the strength we're looking for. The everlasting strength to come out here to do the Lord's work. You know, strive for the truth unto death, and the Lord shall fight for thee. All right? So that's what we out here to do, to get you so-called blacks and Latinos to the spirit of the Lord, to strive for the truth unto death. All right? That's what we all about. That's what's up, man. Y'all working hard, huh, bro? That's what's up, man. Hey, can I show you one scripture right quick?
No, sir. I ain't gonna never stop my job.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You good. I know you gotta do what you gotta do. Ain't nothing wrong with that. But, yeah, what's that? I'm gonna say, call Allah, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah, and Shalom.